In this movie, we're going to take a brief look at the essential sound and the essential graphics panel. We're going to start with the essential sound panel because it has some similarities to effect workflows. And if you've ever used the Lumetri panel, you'll feel right at home with this. So I have a shot here in my timeline with some dialogue. I'm going to click on it and move my playhead earlier. And let's just take a listen to what our subject is saying.
The harder it is to get into your account, the better. Businesses should use modern two-factor authentication. For businesses, consider using a two-factor modern authentication key.
Now, in this example, the sound is fairly good, but we could enhance it in various ways by using the Essential Graphics panel. One thing you should note that if you've looked at the effects panel, there are several sound effects, but in some ways, the Essential sound is a little bit more intuitive in the way that it applies it. I have my essential sound panel brought up here on the right-hand side, and you can go to the window menu and select essential sound to bring it up. And with my clip selected, I'll identify this as dialogue. Here are several sections available to us to add certain effects based on potential problems within our shots, as well as adding creativity or enhancing the clarity of the dialogue in our shot. Let's head to the repair section and choose to reduce some of the noise in our shot. And I want you to see that once I check this, essential sound essentially went into the effects panel, found an effect called denoise in, and added it to our clip. And in fact, if I lower this, the essential sound panel is connected to that effect and make the adjustment to the specific property that's needed to get rid of some of that noise in the shot. I'll just play this back.
Two-factor authentication. For businesses, consider using a two-factor modern authentication key.
I'll press the space bar to stop. Now I'm gonna go and close down the repair section, and let's just take a look here at the clarity section, where we have an option under EQ to use a preset. And by default, even selecting EQ, we get a graphic equalizer effect on our clip. Again, you can find this in the effects panel, to which we can add some vocal presence to our shot. Based on the amount value that we give it, you can see what it's doing to your shot. And let's just give this a playback.
An industry provider named Yubico supports one-time password encryption from an inserted USB port key.
The essential sound panel overall is going to grab specific effects from your effects panel and place it onto your clip. Same thing with the Lumetri panel, except it's dedicated to the Lumetri effect and just has a lot of controls. One other section of the essential sound panel that you should know about is the browse section, where you can do a search for various songs from Adobe Stock that you can use inside your project now. You should know that the text tool, as well as your shape tools, are connected to it. And if we go to the window menu, and go to Essential Graphics, there are some similarities with that in Essential Sound. One is there's a browse section where we could add a series of templates that were either created in After Effects or Premiere Pro to use as a starting point for creating our title. The other part of the browse section is a connection to Adobe Stock, where we can search for a bunch of free as well as paid templates that we can add to our project. Here in Adobe Stock, I'll just do a search for free. There are quite a few, in fact, 4 pages. And if you find something you like, you can tap on the info button to find out more information, and then click the cloud button to download that to your system. The other part of Essential Graphics, if I go back in the browse category, is the edit section, which will display settings based on the text that you have in the timeline. If I selected my type tool and type in here Lake Louise, notice that a graphic layer has been added to your project based on where my playhead is. And if I have it selected, I can see its properties down here for the text. Now, if you're using the legacy titler, I would recommend on future projects to start using Essential Graphics in the new type tool, as I believe the legacy titler will eventually be faded out. So there's your overview of Essential Sound and Essential Graphics. There's some fantastic courses in the library that you can check out that dive into this in more detail that you should definitely check out.